You know, Dusty and I are such great friends. I'm only teasing. We just
news
met
to me.
The show. I know, we have a little thing going, but we don't want to announce it immediately. Yes, it was wonderful. I'm still tasting it.
Thanks for coming
on. A pleasure.
Bye-bye.
I did 2 years or 3 years for the BBC and one for ITV, I think. And they were fairly hectic, because I can't see cue cards. And besides, I don't think anyone had cue cards then. I certainly didn't have autoprompters or anything. So, I mean, I had to learn it all. I spent half of the break, you know, the dinner break, when I was supposed to be putting the makeup on, running up and down to the sound booth, trying to get them to accept things like Jimi Hendrix's volume. They were just going ashen-faced when I went up there, you know? Everything had gone, the meters had totally gone, and going, that's the way it's supposed to sound. One of the nice things about doing those shows was I was just allowed to pick my own material. And as such, because I had a fairly eclectic taste in music, well, a very eclectic taste, thanks to my upbringing, I was able to sort of draw on that, and nobody thought it was odd. It was sort of just Dusty having a go.
When Lagan's dreams sing lullabies, they grow. Like a lovesick lemon, he had my heart in thrall. No life I own, nor liberty. His love.
I'm a happy knocker upper and I'm popular beside, cause I wake them with a cuppa and tasty mother's pride. Then they're off in a flash and a rush.
It's the bread
and a dash and a push.
It's the bread
with a flash and a dash and a rush and a push.
Like I said, it's the bread.
It's the mother's pride bread. It makes them love work. They're going berserk to get off to work. It's in the way I wake them, by by bringing to the side the bread we freshly bake 'em. Fantastic Mother's Pride.
It's the way you make me feel the moment I'm close to you. It's a feeling so unreal, somehow I can't believe it's true. The pounding I feel in my heart, the hoping that we'll never part. I can't believe this is really happening to me. I close my eyes and count to 10, and when I open them, you're still here. I close my eyes and count again. I can't believe it, but you're still here.
I like much more ambient sound and wilder sound, and so I used to record in the corridors mainly because there was some ambience to it, and the best was Ladies' Loo. That was great. Much to the surprise of the cleaners one morning, about 6, I was doing Close My Eyes and Count to 10. I heard all this clanking down the end of the corridor, and they were standing there in their sort of print pinnies, going, what's she doing? It really was the best sound in there. It was a little echoey, and there was no control over it, but it gave it that sound. I've never thought of myself as being a singer with an orchestra. I am part of the orchestra, part of the ensemble. I'm another instrument, and I like to be, that's why I like surround sound. I like to be part of it. So that's why I like Summer of 11. And singing something off the wall like Poor Wayfaring Stranger, which I did on one of the early BBC shows.
I am a poor wayfaring stranger, wandering all this world of woe. And there's no sickness, toil, or danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going.
Strange, an old folk song that came from the Appalachians. It was probably originally Scottish. But I'm going home to see my father. It's so beautiful. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over home. It's really a beautiful song.